Today, I want to emphasize the weapons of the Christian faith. The weapons of the Christian faith. And number 20, it is the means by which we overcome the accuser of the brethren. Revelation chapter 12 and verse 11. Let us turn to that passage of scripture. Revelation chapter 12 and verse 11. 12:11. It is so important that we prepare ourselves for spiritual battle. I was looking at an outline today that deals with magic, witchcraft, and sorcery. And as you well know, that these operations are very prevalent in our society, in our communities, amongst the rich, amongst the poor, and amongst all races. People are heavily engaged in witchcraft, sorcery, magic. It means that we as a people of God living in this society must not be naive. In fact, the Word of God tells us that we are not ignorant of the devil's devices, because as we have learned here, that his mission is to steal, his mission is to kill, and his mission is to destroy. Let's take a look at the verse again. John 10:10, that he comes to steal, he comes to kill, and he comes to destroy. Jesus says, I am come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. So God wants us to have our best life now. Can you give somebody a real big smile and tell them, have your best life now? Amen. Have your best life now. Because that's what that verse literally says. That verse literally says, I am come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. God wants you to have life in the overflowing. God wants you to have life in the overflowing. But while God wants you to have life in the overflowing, your adversary is going about to steal, kill, and destroy. Now, and it's amazing that people who just don't like you, sometimes some of them have no reason why they don't like you. Sometimes you are meeting them for the first time on a job. Sometimes you are meeting them for the first time meeting a friend. And all of a sudden they don't want you, you know, to be in their surroundings. Or you're doing a business and you're trying to do some business. And you go and you bounce up the wrong people. And when I say the wrong people, people who you really, wonder why in the world these people have come into my life. Or these people have crossed my path. But you see, the thing about it is that you cannot allow them to depress you or suppress you. You cannot allow the devil to overcome you. And in spite of they getting involved in their magic, in their sorcery, in their witchcraft, you must have a defense. You must walk with a defense. And we have learned that the blood of Jesus Christ is the believer's defense to overcome and to serve as his or her protection as it relates to living and walking in this world victoriously. We as a people of God, we also must function in spiritual authority. The Lord wants us to function in spiritual authority. In fact, the Word of God tells us, for this purpose, this is a strong word here, for this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works or the workings of the devil. The Son of God was manifested, he might destroy the works or the workings of the devil. In fact, Jesus in Revelation, in the revelation, amen, of his mission in the earth, had already, amen, seen the devil falling. In fact, the Word of God tells us in the book of Luke's Gospel, chapter 10 and verse 19. In fact, let's read from verse 18. Luke chapter 10 and verse 18. Amen. And he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fallen from heaven. He said, I saw him as lightning fallen from heaven. Who is this? Amen. You know, Isaiah the prophet gives us a tremendous, amen, revelation as it relates to the fall of Satan. Isaiah, amen, said that he saw him, amen, falling from heaven. Amen. Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 12. Amen. Isaiah chapter 14 and verse 12. Isaiah said, how art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations? Amen. You see, God in his mission towards the redemption of man, God in his mission towards redemption of man, had a tremendous feat to accomplish, because the devil, the arch rival of your soul, amen, who goes to seek to steal, to kill, and to destroy, amen, God wanted to render him totally helpless to those who would come under the redemptive work of his Son, Jesus Christ. Oh, that's why you and I, we have to accept the redemptive work of Jesus Christ. The redemptive work of Jesus Christ, amen, was manifested in the suffering of Christ. Isaiah chapter 53. Let's take a look at it. In Isaiah chapter 53, amen, we see Jesus Christ, amen, manifesting that kind of suffering. Amen. Oh, yes. The Word of God tells us about the kind of suffering that Jesus Christ had to undertake. The Word of God says in Isaiah 53 and verse 5, he was wounded for our transgressions. Now the word wounded, amen, it speaks about being damaged, severely, amen, hampered, amen. Here it is, Jesus was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement, the whippings, that's what chastisement is, of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. All the scars, all the cuts on his body, amen, that caused the blood to ooze, the wounds upon his body that caused the blood to ooze, amen. Oh yes, the way he was afflicted, amen, the stripes that was placed upon him, amen, that caused the blood to flow. I want you to know, it's a demonstration, amen, of God's ultimate sacrifice. Oh yes, when John saw Jesus, he didn't actually see him, amen, as a mere man when he came to the Jordan River to be baptized of him. When John saw him, John says, amen, look him who is preferred before me. Look him whose shoes lacings I am unable to, or not worthy to untie. Look him, amen. He is the Lamb of God which taketh away the sins of the world. I want you to know, amen, Jesus, amen, was manifested to deal with what the devil, amen, had instigated. The devil had instigated, amen, for man to, amen, to become disobedient to God and to fall away from God so that he can manipulate, he can control man. But oh my goodness, for this purpose was the Son of God manifested, that he can change that. Somebody said, change that. Jesus Christ has come to change what the devil meant for evil. God has come to change it, amen, through the suffering of Jesus Christ, so that you can have life and have it more abundantly. That's right. That's right. That's why you have to understand the precepts of Jesus. The precepts, you have to understand it. You have to walk, not just understand it, but walk in the precepts of it. Because, you see, you are the one who is deputized. You are deputized, amen, to release this power. You are deputized to release it. Now, the blood works, amen, for you to overcome. The blood works for you to overcome. Revelations, let's look at it again. Amen. Chapter 12 and verse 11. Revelations 12, 11. Amen. The word of God says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. Amen. It is so important that you, amen, you walk under the covering of Jesus Christ, and you have his word in you. You gotta speak this word. Let's touch somebody next to you and say, speak the word of God. Oh, speak the word of God. It is important, amen, that you have the word, amen. You have the word, amen. I told you before of a young man, amen, who came, amen, because I went to the courthouse looking for him. Amen. He was, amen, you talk about trouble, one place you're sure going to find him, they told me from the community, is that you're going to find him in the courthouse. Amen. So they said, I think he has case today. So you're going to meet him there, Pastor. I got down there. By the time I got down there, he was out of there. Amen. Amen. No witnesses showed up and had to dismiss the case. Amen. And I decided, amen, that I'm going to keep looking for him. In fact, before I could, amen, look for him again, he'd been hearing I looking for him so badly. Amen, I was looking for him more than the police, amen. Amen, I had a mission from God for that young man. And I said to him, amen, said, I'm going to find him. And to my amazement, by the time I got back to my office from the courthouse, here he was in front of my church. He and one of his goons. Amen. They look dread, man. These guys look dread. And they said, and he began threatening me. He began threatening me and telling me he don't want me to be looking for him. He doesn't want me to be asking people for him. I said to him, God wants to change your life, young man. I said, that's the only purpose I'm looking for you, because in my heart I feel God, amen, wants to change your life and put purpose in your life. And he said to me, he said, my God is Jah Rastafari. I said, I know him. He said, what do you mean by you know him? I said, I'm much older than you. I said, I said, he came to our nation in the 60s. Jara Stefan, I stood on Tragret Road in my school uniform and I waved at him. And I said, sir, he is no God. I said, I waved at him, he's dead. I said, what you need one who is dead and is alive. You need one who went to the grave, amen, and the grave couldn't hold him. His name is Jesus Christ. Amen. His name is Jesus Christ. He told me, he said, right now your God is talking too much. He said, I'll take it out, you know, Pastor. I'll take it out. Your God is talking too much. I said, even though if you take it out, amen, every drip of blood that falls on the ground off of my mouth, it would be testifying against you. You would not be able to rest if you should ever take my blood. You will not ever able to rest. He said, you're real brave, Pastor. I said, no. I'm saying I'm not brave. It's just that I'm not afraid of him who can kill the body. And after that, he can do nothing with it. I rather fear him who can kill both body and soul and cast it into hell. Amen. And it seems as though God just put a boldness on me while talking to this young man that he and his goon eventually said, I see you, I'm leaving you alone. I go on. Amen. I'm leaving you alone. I said, but I still want to see you. Amen. God wants to change you. A couple of days after, he called me. He said, please come up in the hole, Pastor. I need to see you up in the hole. Amen. I said, Lord Jesus. Amen. It makes no sense running. Amen. Amen. I'm on front page. I'm on main road, major street. Amen. So I went up in the hole. He asked all the guys to step aside. You know what that young man told me? He said, Pastor, he said, I never felt fear in all my life until the day you spoke to me. He said, it seems as though there was something that came out of you that instead of I coming to scare you and threaten you, there was something greater inside of you that fear caused me to fear. Caused me to fear. Listen to me. My God, our God, somebody help me here. Our God is a consuming fire. Our God is a consuming fire. Amen. Our God will burn up every work of darkness. Our God will make small the devil. Amen. That young man said to me, he said, Pastor, I know, I just sense I am going down. I'm going down. I just sense I'm going down. He said, but you see what you gave me there? I want a Bible and I want a dictionary. He said, can you bring it for me? Amen. I said, yes, you'll get it. Amen. A couple months after, he was gunned down. Amen. He was a dead man. I want you to know, amen, that the wicked may spread themselves like a green bay tree, but soon they will be no more. But amen, I want you to know that the righteous is like the tree of life. Amen. Bursts forth, amen, planted by the rivers of water, amen, that brings forth its fruit in its season. God will always bless you when you are righteous. God will always bless you, amen, when you are covered by the blood of Jesus Christ, amen. But I want you to do a little more, church. I want you to do a little more. I want you to be bold like a lion. I want you to be bold like a lion and recognize that Jesus have empowered you. Jesus has deputized you. Jesus has given you the ability to overcome. Let's take a look at it. Amen. In the book of Luke's gospel, chapter 10, amen, and verse 19, Jesus said when he saw Satan falling from heaven, verse 18, when he saw him falling from heaven like lightning, he went on to say in the 19th verse, he says, behold, I give you power. Behold, I give you power. I give you power. Oh, hallelujah. Just
stand up on your feet a little bit. Just stand up on your feet. Amen. I am almost sure we are not packed out tonight. And so there's a little space between you. Just walk with some attitude, man. Just walk across your space with some attitude. Behold, I give you power. Amen. Come on and say, behold, I have power. I have power. You don't have to walk too fast. Just take your time. Behold, I have power. I have power to tread upon serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt me. Come on and lift your hands to God and give God worship. Lift those hands and recognize that you are not weak. You are not, amen, anemic. You are not, amen, an infidel. You are not, amen, a defeated foe. You are an overcomer. You overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of the testimony. You are an overcomer. In the name of Jesus Christ, you have power to tread upon. Hallelujah. You have power to tread upon. What is there that looked like it wanted to bite you and kill you? You have power to overcome that which wants to bite you and kill you. That you have power to overcome that which is working in the dark against you. You have the power to overcome magic. You have the power to overcome sorcery. You have the power to overcome witchcraft. The power of Jesus Christ. Nothing shall hurt you. Come on, I'm covered under the blood. Come on, declare it. Under the blood I am covered. Under the blood I am covered. Under the blood I am covered. I'm covered under the blood. Put your hands together and give God a great praise. Covered under the blood. Sit down. Covered under the blood. You covered. Covered under the blood. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let them do their witchcraft. Let them do their sorcery. Let them do their magic. It, amen, it cannot touch you. It cannot hurt you. All you have to do is to rise up in the name of Jesus Christ. Rise up in the name of Jesus Christ. Declare the name of Jesus Christ. Mark 16:17. In Mark 16:17, the word of God tells us, amen, these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devils. They shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. Listen to me. There is a revelation that is coming out of your mouth. Amen. There is a revelation. That's why you got to stay under the blood. You got to stay under the covering, because Jesus is going to give you revelation, knowledge. Listen to me. You need understanding from God. Just raise your hands before God and say, God, give me understanding in the name of Jesus Christ. Give me understanding in the name of Jesus Christ. You need understanding. Hallelujah. You need understanding. That's why I love this passage of scripture in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 24. In Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 24, the word of God tells us, amen, about the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. The blood of Jesus Christ. The word of God tells us, and to Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant, and to the blood of sprinkling that speaks speaketh better things than that of Abel. Amen. I want you to know, amen, that you better not refuse him that speaketh. Amen. Don't you refuse him. Let's take a look at the 25th verse, the next verse. Amen. See that you refuse not him that speaketh. For if they escape not who refuse him that spake on earth, much more shall we escape if we, amen, turn away from him that speaketh from heaven. I want you to know it is extremely important that you recognize, amen, that your God, amen, must be treated acceptably. Your God must be treated with godly fear. Let's take a look at the 28th verse. In the 28th verse we read, wherefore we receive a kingdom which cannot be removed. Just tell somebody, no. Amen. Where I stand, where I sit, where I move, where I have my being, I cannot remove. I'm in a stable place. Amen. Let us have grace whereby we may serve God acceptably and with reverence and with a godly fear. Listen to me. As long as you serve God with that kind of reverence, with that kind of commitment, with that kind of godly fear, you don't have to be afraid of the wicked. Amen. You don't have to be afraid of what man can do. Guess what? Somebody say, watch. Guess what? I can't hear you. Guess what? Amen. Am I still hearing you? Guess what? Take a look at the next verse. The next verse tells it all, that our God is a consuming fire. Come on and stand on your feet and begin to worship that God. Your God is able to topple the workings of the enemy and pull down the strongholds. Pull down the strongholds of Satan. Come on. Your God is a consuming fire. Your God is a consuming fire. Your God is able to change your situation. Amen. Your situation. Hallelujah. I don't know what kind of necromancy. I don't know what kind of sorcery. I don't know what kind of witchcraft or magic they're working against you. But I want you to know the fire of God is all around me. The fire of God. Just make a turn around and say, God, thank you. The fire is all around me. Oh, hallelujah. The fire will burn up. Will burn up every work of the devil. The fire is messing up every work of witchcraft. Come on and worship your God for the fire today. Worship him for the fire. The fire is on your side. The fire to burn. The fire to sanctify. The fire to cleanse. The fire to purge. Shadrach, Meshach, and a bad Negro. Amen. They were thrown into Nebuchadnezzar's fire. Now Nebuchadnezzar said, if you wouldn't bow to me, amen, you are going to burn. But little did Nebuchadnezzar know that there is a fire that we can live in. Amen. In the midst of any fire. You can live in the midst of any fire. Let them bring the trials. Let them bring the persecution. You are born in the fire. The fire is already around you. Their fire cannot burn you. Hear me. Their fire Their fire cannot burn you. Cannot burn you. There is a phenomenon that my entire community will never forget. My big, beautiful, new, amen, well-kept church. Some of you know my church in Digger Martin. Amazingly, beautifully designed. Amen. They called me from home and they said, Pastor, the church is on fire. The house next door is burning. The firemen are on the compound. And the people from all over the hills that saw the fire blazing. The trees next on the side of the church is on fire. Burning. And the firemen are fighting this fire. Fighting this fire. I came down and I folded my hands. And I said to God, God, are you going to let this church burn? Amen. And I am not ready for a new building as yet. Amen. I'm not ready for a new building. Are you going to let this church? And people saying, yes, the church on fire. And listen to me, I took pictures of this thing. The church, the side of the church is on fire. The side of the church is, and the firemen are fighting the fire. I say, God, you are not going to let this church burn down. The house next door is already engulfed in flame. The gas tanks are blowing up in the inside of the house. And I say, God, not this church. Amen. I need to put some more insurance in this church if this church have to burn, God. Amen. And that's the truth. I went and put more insurance in the church. It can burn now. Amen. 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 I said, God, this church must not burn. Listen to me. And while the amen, everybody said, yes, Pastor, your church on fire. Amen. All of a sudden, amen, the firemen, amen, came outside and they said, Pastor, it is not the church is on fire. It is the church, it's the trees hanging over the church that is on fire. Now that is a paradox in itself. How could the side of the church burning, the trees hanging over the church is burning, and the fireman is saying, no, we inside here, Pastor, and the church is not on fire. Guess what? When everything was settled and the smoke came in, amen, dissipated, nobody, amen, could have, amen, seen the church burn. Amen. Is one fireman, amen, pump his hose into one of my windows, and the only thing that got broken was a window pane inside of the church. Listen to me, my God can keep anything in the midst of fire, because our God is a consuming fire. High five somebody next to you and say, I'm not afraid of fire. The hotter the battle, the sweeter the victory. Tell them, the hotter the battle, the sweeter the victory. Let them come. Let the devil do what he has to do. But our God is going to defend us. Our God is going to fight for us. Our God is a way maker. Lift your hands to God and give God thanks that your God has made a way for you. Your God has made a way for you. Your God, your God, your God, you have to learn to fight, church. Somebody said, today we fight. Today we fight. Come on and say, today we fight. Today we fight. Today we fight. Say it again, today we fight. Today we fight. Say it again, today we fight. Today we fight. We are going to fight. Hallelujah. We are going, hallelujah. We are going to fight. Amen. We are going to stay strong in God. The enemy shall not have us. Amen. The devil, amen, will do his thing, but God will do greater. Somebody say, God is greater. God is greater. The weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Come on, you got to keep going. You are not looking for the undertaker. Just touch somebody and say, no, I am not looking for the undertaker. I am looking for the uppertaker. My God is going to deliver me. My God is going, come on. My God is going to deliver me. Somebody need to praise God. You are fighting. You are overcoming. You are more than a conqueror. You are an overcomer. Come on, church. Amen. And bless the Lord.
One young man featured on CNN recently was so blinded when he said that he feels that Islam is an upgrade from Christianity. I looked at this young man in his 20s, amen, a jihadist, and I said to him, amen, I am so glad that I don't have to die for my God. My God died for me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My God is greater. Hallelujah. Because my God says, destroy this temple. Destroy this temple. You put this temple to lay down, and in 3 days I will pick it up. Amen. I want to thank God. Muhammad might be a great leader, but when you get to Muhammad's tomb, I've been there. I have been to the Middle East 5 times. And when you get to Muhammad's tomb and you watch at Muhammad's tomb, is R.I.P. rest in peace. But I went to the Garden of Gethsemane and I looked at Jesus's tomb, and the stone was rolled away, and there was a sign that says, he is not here, he is risen. Come on, we have a Savior. We have a Savior. We have a Lord. We have a Master. Come on and give God praise. You feel tonight that you are dealing with some sickness. You are dealing with some evil. I want you, amen, to come and rest your hand on the altar and say, God, I surrender it all. You are my winner. I'm an overcomer. Just run down here and get back up. Just rest your hand on the altar in the name of Jesus. And say, I claim healing. I claim deliverance. I claim mercy. Amen. Amen. Just do it and get back out. Somebody else wants to come. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, make it quickly. Somebody else wants to come. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A Savior who can take a poor lost sinner, lift him from the miry clay, and set him free. Set him free. Set him free. Claim your deliverance. Lift your hands. Talk to God and say, tonight I'm a conqueror. I'm healed. I'm delivered. I'm set free. In Jesus' name, I'm free. I'm glad about it. I'm glad about it. I'm free. Now, it could have been easy. It could have been easy
for me to tell you to bring an offering and rest it on the altar when you're coming. But you see, I don't want nobody who, amen, just join us, amen, to say, here's another gimmick and here's another trick. So I let you come and receive a spiritual connection. Amen. Because people like to criticize and they like to, amen, use every means to say another trick by the preachers. But I want you to know that the blood of Jesus Christ is a guaranteed, amen, deliverance. You overcome him. Put it up on the board. Revelation 12 and verse 11. You overcome him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of the testimony. There is safety in you in Christ. There is safety in you in Christ. There is deliverance in you in Christ. Go with victory. Victory is yours.